Welcome to the Grumpy Gobbler channel. This is the 2023 year in review. This video is quite long, but hopefully you'll enjoy it. Thanks for coming along. Episode 1 was in February, and there wasn't a lot of snow, surprisingly. It wouldn't be too long before the snow got so deep I couldn't get back out to this area. Episode 2 was from the very next week. There was a lot more snow, which of course I loved. In the first week of May, I went out to the San Rafael Swell for a few days with June and some friends. I wasn't quite ready to leave the San Rafael Swell, so I stayed an extra day after everybody else went home. I didn't camp solo again until May 18th. The snow had mostly melted. There were some in the high mountains, but obviously none where I'm camping. 2 weeks later, I go back out to the same area, and this time I find rain, hail, thunderstorms, and a bit of drama. After the awning episode, I decided to leave, but then I decided I was being a wuss, so I actually turned around, came right back to the same spot, faced my 4Runner in the other direction, and continued my camp. And boy, am I glad I did. I was in store for some awesome thunderstorms, some hail, good lightning. It was awesome. June, my wife June and I head back out to the San Rafael swell for her birthday. We have an awesome time. We deal a little bit with rain, but no big deal. We do have one scary incident, which you'll see in a minute. So just as we started heading down this canyon, the rain really started coming down and this clay just turned into a snotty mess. And it started getting a little scary, so we actually just turned around slowly and headed back up to the top. Episode 8, I go back to one of my favorite spots, And as you can see, everything is really green. It's beautiful. I love winter camping, but camping when it's green like this is just stunning. I just have to deal with a lot more people. For this camp, I go back to the same basic area, but I try a different camp spot. This spot has an unobstructed view of the pass and is just stunningly beautiful with all the green. For this camp, I go to the same area, but I go on the other side of the pass. I wanted to search around and see if I could find some good camping on the other side. And I found one really cool spot, as you will see. In episode 11, I go out for a very rainy camp. It is stunningly beautiful, albeit a bit wet. Too bad YouTube doesn't have smell-o-vision because the smells were fantastic. In episode 12, I head up to another one of my favorite spots. It is stunningly beautiful as per usual. And as you can see, the snow has started to fall in Colorado. It was a bit socked in, but still just quiet, peaceful, and beautiful. Episode 13, I camp in an extremely windy spot. It's beautiful, but wow, the wind. It was crazy. Episode 14 brings me to northwestern Colorado, which is a beautiful area and totally undiscovered. There's hardly anybody there. I came out here for 2 days. It was a fantastic, relaxing time. And again, as per usual, and I say a lot, the scenery, spectacular. In October, I go back out to the San Rafael Swell with my friends Chris and Mike. We go for, I think, like 3 days. Fantastic time. I didn't post a video on this, but here you go. For episode 15, I go back to my favorite spot, one of my favorite spots, and by now, most of the green is gone. Just means winter is coming. By early November, the cold is really starting to set in Colorado, and so I go back to one of my favorite winter areas and have a nice camp there. For episode 18, I finally get to camp in some good snow, and it even snows a little bit on me over the night. It's just a winter wonderland. So beautiful out here, as you can see. For episode 19, I go back out to a good winter camping area when you can get out there. Sometimes it snows too deep and I can't get out there. But tons of camping spots out here, and I have a nice winter camp. For my final camp of the year, I go back out to a spot you've probably seen many times on my channel and have a very beautiful last camp of the year. I'd like to thank everybody that's come along this year, all my subscribers, both new and old, everybody that comments, especially you guys that comment on almost all my videos. I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed everything that I put out this year, and I look forward to sharing more videos with you next year. I hope you all had a great Christmas, and I have a safe and happy New Year's. Thanks again for joining me.